I can now, I've got Resolve, DaVinci Resolve installed. I can now encode my videos straight out in AV1, straight out of this on the Mac 5.1. And then the nicer, smaller, then you can upload them. Also, obviously, this has got built-in H265 and H264 encoders. So, it's not brilliant. It's nowhere near as fast as the M3. But the card that went in here is 250 quid. I don't know. I mean, I'll go through what's in it. But it's 250 quid. I mean, that thing's £2,500. And it's like twice as fast. So you can pick one of these up for 200 or 300 quid. You can get some RAM really cheaply. You can get the card really cheaply. And, you know, if you've got one, I think the best thing is if you've got one of these already, you can switch it to Windows and basically put this card in it. You've got a great encoding machine. You've got a content creation machine if you want to use it. And yeah, so it sort of lives on, but now it's Windows 11. So there's a half thing. If you want to leave that, you know, the Mac world behind and switch over and get a powerful video card in here. I mean, I've not tested it with any other ones like the TIs, but this is a base RTX 460. Then watch the video. If you're set on using, Mac OS, then not for you. However, that still boots into Mojave, even with an RTX 460 unit. I'll show you that. Because obviously it did have, they had native drivers in the earlier versions of OS X to allow you to use a video card. There's no acceleration on it, but it works. So yeah, so what we'll do is I'll just show it to you. I'll talk you through it, basically what I did to get it to this state, and you can take it from there.